So good morning again. So last Monday, our discussion centered on the definition of what religion is. Okay? And we were able to settle with the fact that religion is something that brings us back to God. Okay, yun yan, no? Pero let us try to be less pious about this definition. It is not really about us being brought back to God in the sense that they want us to be more observant of religious rituals and belief. Rather, in the social sciences, religion means that we are being brought back to God. We are being brought back to the realization and appreciation of an absolute reality, an absolute truth that is beyond us. In other words, it makes us realize how man is limited, how man is restricted, how man is vulnerable. And number two, we are being brought back to the realization that everybody lives in a community and we have a certain responsibility to perform. So, in other words, ladies, yung religion, ang social value niya is for us to be number one, moral, and number two, for us to be able to live in community. So, dalawang social value ng religion. Maging mabuting tao at maging para sa ibang tao. Okay, so yun yung sense natin. Tapos, last one day also, we were able to identify that religion in Asia, sabi natin, Asia is the cradle of the different religious movements. So, in-outline natin lahat yon. Sabi natin, the great and the biggest, most widespread religious movements in the world originated in Asia. So, ano yung mga yon? Hinduism, Buddhism, Judaism, Christianity, Islam, Taoism, Shintoism, and Confucianism. Lahat yan nanggaling sa Asia. Pero, clarify natin last Monday that religion and philosophy in Asia, they are not two conflicting realities. Kasi there is an attitude that when we are philosophical, we tend to be non-religious. Because when you are philosophical, you tend to be an atheist. That is very, very Western, very European perspective. Why? Because we think that philosophy makes us reason out more. Now, when we reason out more, we tend to clarify to ourselves the superstitious nature of religion. Ayan yung iniisip natin. Pag pinagduktong natin yung religion at philosophy. Pag naging religious ka, hindi ka pwedeng magiging masyadong philosophical because you are supposed to be subscripting to particular set of religious belief na inaasahan sa'yo masyado kang masunuring, masyado kang observant lang. Hindi ka na dapat mag-reason out. At on the other way around, pag philosophical ka naman, you cannot be religious because you have to be able to explain well and explore well the rigorous manner the things that you believe in. Hindi pwedeng tanggap ka lang ng tanggap. Hindi pwedeng basta-basta lang naniniwala. So, sa Western perspective, ganon. Religion and philosophy may have some sense of animosity between them. Okay? Magkalaban sila. Pagka-philosophical ka, hindi ka pwedeng religious. At pag religious ka, hindi pwedeng ikaw ay philosophical. That is our common perception. Pero in Asia, as we discussed last Monday, religion and philosophy are interconnected. How is that? Babalikan natin ulit yung description natin or definition natin of what religion is. Religion is bringing us back to the truth. So yun yung goal. Our goal is to become truthful person. At yung truth na yan is something that's beyond us. something that is beyond our limited capacity. But we want to be immersed in that truth. Because by being immersed in that truth, we realize we can be good. Okay? Pero pag sinabi natin philosophy, philosophy is love of wisdom. Then, therefore, love of the truth. In other words, it is the means to becoming good. So, papaano yon? Ang ibig sabihin, philosophy is not just a discipline. Philosophy for Asians is not just a field of study. Hindi lang siya subject na pinag-aaralan. Hindi lang siya course na ina-undergo ng isang tao. Pero if it is about a mechanism towards becoming good, it is a lifestyle. So yung mga tao sa Asia ay hindi lamang nag-iisip in compartmentalized values, pero they are in themselves living philosophically so that they are able to find the truth that is being offered to them by religion. So ulitin ko ha, tapusin natin yung discussion between religion and philosophy. Ang religion, that's the goal, that offers the goal of man being good. But philosophy offers us the mechanism of how it is to be good by living out that sensitivity of finding, of looking, of loving the truth. Pagka minahal mo yung truth, ang ibig sabihin niyan, hindi ka lang basta-basta nag-iisip. Pero you are also sensitive over the needs of others. You are also sensitive over the interconnectivity between people. You are also sensitive over your own self-consciousness. Hindi ka na-detach sa mundo. Hindi ka na-detach over things that are happening around you. Okay? So, that is the relationship between religion and philosophy in Asia. Ngayon, tignan natin, how are the religions in Asia characterized? Paano natin masasabi yung mga religions sa Asia as philosophical? Okay? Yung mga particular religions. Now, let us look at this. I will give you time to search for a very quick and brief description of the different religions. Okay, first, the oldest religion in Asia is Hinduism. Okay, Hinduism. Okay, Hinduism was developed in the Indus Valley. Okay, in the Indus Valley. If you can recall, I touched on the early civilizations in Asia. One of these early civilizations is the Indus Valley Civilization. And part of that Indus Valley Civilization is the creation of Hinduism. Who created Hinduism? Who founded Hinduism? It was the Aryan people. Okay? The Aryan people. And Hinduism, technically right now, is characterized to be a polytheistic belief. Pag sinabi natin polytheistic belief, it is a religion that subscribes to the worship of many gods. Okay? Yan yung impression ng Hinduism. It was created by the Aryans and it is polytheistic in orientation. But now I will be giving you 30 seconds. Can you just search for things that would clarify to us, okay, kung ano pa ang Hinduism? Okay, maghanap kayo sa internet ng mga characteristics of Hinduism. Okay, go! Okay, sabi ni Samantha, Hinduism is an Indian religion of Dharma. Dharma. Mamaya, tignan natin kung anong ibig sabihin ng Dharma or a way of life. Ano ba tinutumbok niyang dharma na yan? Okay, very good. Samantha. Sabi ni Sandra, nag-search siya ng mga pictures at nakita niya yung secret symbol of the Om. But, Om. Com. Yan yun. Okay? And different pictures of the Indian Pantheon. Ibig sabihin, the different gods of the Hindu religion. Very good, Sandra. How about the others? Okay, Hinduism is the third largest religion in the world. Technically, because India is now overcoming China as the country with the biggest population. I think they have 1.2 billion people living now in India. And so, the foremost religion is Christianity. That's the biggest, the religion with the biggest number of followers, followed by Islam, and then by Hinduism. Okay, sabi ni Sandra, sorry, your face is there. Okay lang yan. Okay, Darlene, very good, thank you. Tapos Erica, Hinduism is a major religious and cultural tradition of Asia which developed from the Vedic religion. Bakit Vedic religion? Because the main scripture of Hinduism is called Vedas. Okay, the Vedas. May apat na klase ng Veda. Okay, may Rig Veda, that is the scripture based on spiritual worth, value, and morality. And the other Vedas focus on rituals, focus on the responsibility of men and women towards other people. Okay, very good. Okay, next. Sabi ni Jana, it's a belief in many gods. Correct, kaya nga siya polytheistic. Okay, the manifestation of a single unity. A belief in the universal law of cause and effect and reincarnation. Medyo malabo yun, mamaya iintindihin natin yan. But that is the heart of what Hinduism is. In an Indian religion, okay, three principal gods, Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva. Okay, sige. Tapos sabi ni Ozzy, Hindu believes in samsara or the cycle of birth and rebirth. Okay, thank you. Now, let's look at Hinduism. Hinduism, based on our discussion, is polytheistic. But in reality, ladies, Hinduism is not polytheistic at all. Rather, it is pantheistic. Okay? Sa totoo lang, hindi siya polytheistic. Ang tingin ng tao, Hinduism, is polytheistic. But it is pantheistic. Ano ibig sabihin ng pantheistic? Everything is God. Yan, everything is God. Hinduism regards everything as God. Why is that so? Because for Hinduism, the essence of everything, the essence of all things is immersed in what we call Brahman. Okay, Brahman. What is Brahman? That is the absolute reality. Oh, katulad nung pinag-aaralan natin nung Monday, sabi natin, religion brings us back to truth. And what is the truth? Absolute reality that is beyond us. So yung Brahman na yan, that is beyond individual persons, that is beyond individual things, that is beyond individual realities and existence. Because Brahman is everything. O, hindi ko nagagawing masyadong philosophical, pang grade 12 yon. Pero ang sinasabi ko lang, si Brahman is everything. Okay? He is immersed in the reality of everything. Therefore, his existence is beyond the existence of each one. So, kaya nagiging pantheistic ang Hinduism because technically, everything is Brahman and everything is God. Now, how come there are the major gods Brahma, Shiva, and Vishnu? Because, of course, remember, it will be quite difficult for people to understand the dynamism of this Brahman if there is no personification attached to him. And so, Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva are personifications of the processes that Brahman is, that is creation, preservation, and destruction. Ngayon, yung 4,000 other gods and goddesses, manifestation yan ni Brahman. Ibig sabihin, pag nakakakita tayo ng ulan, that is Brahman. Let's name that god something as such. Okay? Okay, pag nakakakita tayo ng masaya or kasayahan or happiness or joy, that's an experience of a person, then let us give a name to that so that we will be able to identify that as an expression of Brahman. So in other words, the 4,000 gods are not individual gods per se. They do not exist per se. Okay? They are actually existing in connection with one another, and they are merely given a name to be labeled. Nilagyan mo lang sila ng pangalan, okay? Nilagyan mo lang sila ng categories para madali natin silang ma-identify. Kasi ang hirap naman na masaya ako, Brahman. Malungkot ako, Brahman. Galit ako, Brahman. I need something to make me happy, Brahman. Oh, parang ang hirap nun. So, these people, they needed to categorize the different expressions of their experiences by giving a name to it. Okay? Kailangan nilang magkaroon ng means to understand it. That's why they put a name to it. Now, at the essence of Hinduism, if Hinduism is pantheistic, ano ang pinaka-heart niyan? Okay? Nakita natin na ang epekto niya sa kultura is the categorization of experiences and putting these experiences with a name. Putting a name on these experiences. That's an effect on culture. Kaya makikita natin, lahat sila maraming ritual, lahat sila marami silang temples. Kasi iba-iba yung temple, iba-iba yung ritual given to the different gods and goddesses. Okay? Ngayon, what is then at the heart of Hinduism? If everything is God, therefore, you have to respect everything. Kahit pa yan maliit na halaman, kahit pa yan insekto, kahit pa yan pangit na hayop, kahit pa yan mapulube, kahit pa yan rapist, kahit pa yan magnanakaw, we have to respect everything because everything is God. Therefore, at the heart of Hinduism is the idea of respect and tolerance. Yan. Okay? So, at the heart of Hinduism is respect and tolerance. So, babalikan natin kung ano yung religion. Religion makes us good. So, ano yung goodness sa Hinduism? Goodness for Hinduism is the ability to respect. Okay? The ability to respect. Hinduism. Now, let's go to Buddhism. Okay? Pag sinabi natin Buddhism, the first impression is that Buddhism developed from Hinduism and it was founded by Siddhartha Gautama. Ayan na, Siddhartha Gautama. Again, 30 seconds. Can you please try to find for definitions, descriptions of what Hinduism is? Hanap ulit kayo. 30 seconds. Ano yung Hindu, Buddhism. Buddhism that developed from Hinduism. Anak siya ng Hinduism. Pero it was created, founded, organized by Siddhartha Gautama. Ayan. Si Sandra ulit. Nagbigay ulit siya ng mga pictures ni Buddha. Okay, ni Buddha. O mamaya, puntahan natin yan. Si Samantha, the world's fourth largest religion with over 520 million followers, and the religions of Buddhism are scattered particularly in East Asia and Southeast Asia and South Asia, particularly in Sri Lanka. Andyan ang mga Buddhists. Ayan. One night, while reflecting under the shade of a Bodhi tree, Siddhartha Gautama gained enlightenment on the true meaning of life. This was why he became known as the Buddha, and since then, Siddhartha devoted his life to preaching to attain eternal happiness. Okay, that's the enlightenment that Siddhartha Gautama attained according to Ozi. We will go back to that later. Thank you very much. Buddhism is a widespread religion or philosophy. Ayan, tama yan. Magandang i-point out, philosophy siya. Okay? And then Buddhism encompasses a variety of traditions, beliefs, spiritual practices largely based on the original teachings attributed to the Buddha and resulting interpreted philosophies. Okay, very good. Buddhism is another large religion in India. It originated in India, yes. But it was transferred to China, Thailand, Sri Lanka, and other East Asian and Southeast Asian countries. Okay? Mali spelling ng Buddhism, darling. Take note of that. Buddhism is a spiritual religion, a tradition that focuses on personal spiritual development and attainment of a deep insight in the true nature of life. Okay, very good. Now let's focus on what Buddhism is. Unang-una, ladies, I want to clarify to you, Buddhism does not regard Buddha as God. Okay? So sa pinaka-pure, the pure form of Buddhism, Buddha or Siddhartha Gautama is not God. He is an enlightened one. Anong ibig sabihin ng enlightened one? Pag sinabi nating enlightened one, somebody who understood the meaning and purpose of life. Oh, ngayon, may God ba ang Buddhism? Sino ang Diyos ng Buddhism? Naalala nyo, sabi ko sa inyo, religion brings us back to the truth. But this truth does not necessarily mean at all times being one with a personal God. A God with a person. It can be an idea. And so we can say Buddhism to be an atheistic religion. Yan. Atheistic religion. Sir, anong ibig sabihin ng atheistic religion? Pag sinabi natin atheistic religion, it does not have a God. Okay? Yung Buddhism, technically, is not directed towards a God. Kaya nga yung sinasabi kanina, philosophical religion, because it's a philosophy, it's a way of life to understand what is life about, what is existence about. Ayan. Tapos, ano ang ibig sabihin nito? Ano ang ibig sabihin ng what is life about? Eh kasi nga, sabi ni Buddha, life is full of suffering. Why are we suffering? Because we are what? Attached to the world. Masyado tayong attached sa mundo. O, example. Meron ka ng iPhone 10. Pero gusto mo ngayon, iPhone 11. Nung may iPhone 11 ka na, gusto mo iPhone 12. O ngayon, anong suffering doon? Sa kakukuha ng pera. Pag hindi ka nagkaroon ng iPhone 12, iisipin mo yung kaklase ko, may iPhone 12 ako, iPhone 11 lang. So you are always suffering. And so people suffer because of our attachment to the world. Let's simplify that. Because of our selfishness. Yun ang sinasabi ng Buddhism. Masyado tayong swapang. Ang tao, swapang. And so sabi ng Buddhism, there is a way to get out of that suffering. And that is through the means of moderation. The eight noble path. Okay, the eightfold noble path. Anong ibig sabihin nun? Let us take the middle way. Anong ibig sabihin ulit ng middle way? You are neither in excess or in insufficiency. Hindi ka sobra, hindi ka kulang, nasa gitna ka lang. Anong ibig sabihin ulit nun? Aminin mo, nagugutom ka. Pero huwag kang kumain ng sobra-sobra kasi sasakit ang tiyan mo. At huwag ka namang magpa-fasting kasi magkaka-ulcer ka. Aminin mo, nagagalit ka. Pero huwag naman yung nagwawala kang nangrarayot ka na. O wag naman yung hindi ka nagpapakita ng galit mo pero nasa loob mo at bigla na lang sasabog pag merong nag-trigger. Wag mo namang sabihin hindi ka inaantok. Oo, inaantok ka. Matulog ka nung kailangan lang. Pero wag namang hindi ka matulog kasi magkakasakit ka. So, Buddhism tells us to always be persons of Moderation. Yan. So sa kanila, ang goodness is about being persons of control. Yan. Be able to control your drives. Be able to control your ambitions. Be able to control your vision. Be a person that moderates his thoughts. Oh, yan na. Yan ang goodness sa Buddhism. Ngayon, let us try to go back to Hinduism. And how is Hinduism similar with Buddhism? Both of these religions believe in what we call samsara. Ano yung samsara? The cycle of birth and rebirth. Anong ibig sabihin yan? We will be reborn into this life unless we are able to attain for Hinduism the idea of dharma. Unless we live out our dharma, what we are supposed to be doing, and for Buddhism, nirvana, or enlightenment, we will not be able to get out of this samsara. Okay? Hindi tayo makakaalis sa cycle of birth and rebirth unless we are able, for Hinduism, live out what we are supposed to live. If you are a teacher, then be a good teacher. If you are a student, then be a good student. If you are a politician, then be a good politician. Yun yung sa Hinduism. Pero sa Buddhism, anong sinasabi? Unless you are able to get rid of our selfishness, unless we are able to get rid of our tendency to acquire things, you will not be able to live out or get out of that samsara, cycle of birth and rebirth. That's Hinduism and Buddhism. Questions? Can you please raise your hand if you did understand the lesson? Yung first part. Naku, wala yatang nakaintindi. Okay. May naintindihan ba dun sa first part natin? Ayan, okay. Oh, you know, meron ng mga bagong versions, yung mga nagta-thumbs up. Okay, galing. Hindi ko pa alam kung paano 'yon. Paano ba 'yon? Ah, ito. Ayun, okay, yung thumbs up pala. Okay, sige. Very good. Very good. Oh, now. So we're done with Hinduism and Buddhism. Now, we'll look at the Abrahamic faith. Okay. The Abrahamic faith are three. Foremost, there is Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. Why do we call them Abrahamic faith? Because we trace these faiths to Abraham. Oh, yan na, to Abraham. Hindi ko na i-discuss kung sino si Abraham. I think you know who Abraham is. He is Father Abraham, the father of Isaac, and you discuss him in CL. So, hindi ko na i-discuss si Abraham. Now, from Abraham, we develop three organized religions. First of this is Judaism, okay, which we look at by impression as the religion of the Jewish people, particularly those people who were given that promise of living in Israel as their own. So yung Judaism na yan, if you look at it, in summary, it is a covenant between God and His people. Okay? It's a covenant between God and His people. Ano yung covenant na yan? Ang sabi ng Diyos, okay, you people will be my own and I will give you this land. And your responsibility to me, that is my responsibility to you, I will take you as my own and I will give you this land. But you have to take me as your God, no other God besides me. That's a covenant between God and His people. What is the context of that? Okay, ladies, if Hinduism and Buddhism originated in India, okay, in India, wherein there is an abundance of resources, ito naman nag-originate sa West Asia, sa deserted area of West Asia, particularly in the desert areas of Iran. Diyan nagsimula ang covenant between God and His people, between Abraham and God. O ano meron ba doon sa deserted area na yan? So yung deserted area na yan, it's interesting to note that it is polytheistic in nature. Polytheistic. O yan ha. So yung sa Iran, maraming Diyos dyan. Okay. And usually, these gods that are in Iran are competing against each other. Why? Because they are dedicated in each of the cities of the Mesopotamian regions, Iran and Iraq. So, iba-iba yung Diyos dyan. At iba-iba yung Diyos na yan, magkakaaway yan, pagalingan yan, pagalingan yung mga tagasunod niyan. Mas makapangyarihan yung Diyos ko kaysa sa Diyos mo. Mas milagroso yung Diyos ko kaysa sa Diyos mo. Yun ang sinasabi natin. That is the context of where Abraham made this covenant between God and himself. Polytheistic ang religion. So, in that particular context, God introduced himself as the only God. Ayan. As the only powerful God. As the only true God. And because he is the only true God, he can topple, okay, all these other gods. So, Judaism is the foremost monotheistic religion. Okay? Monotheistic religion. Pag sinabi natin monotheistic religion, a belief in one God. That is, in Judaism, Yahweh. Okay? Ngayon, pag sinabi natin, let me just clarify to you, very quick lang, baka kayo may mabasang bagay at sabi nyo, mali-mali tinuturo ni Sir Bunyag. O, ganito yon. Yung Judaism, sinasabi natin, it's the first formal and organized monotheistic religion. Bakit formal and organized? Kasi until now, it's happening. It is practice. Ladies, for your information, around 4,000 years ago in Egypt, there is a monotheistic movement. Okay? At yun ay pinasimulan ng pharaoh called Akhenaton or Amenhotep. Oh yes, si Amenhotep IV na ginawa niyang pangalan niya Akhenaton in honor of the sun god Aton. Pero yon hindi naman nagtuloy. After he died, they reverted back to polytheism. So, we don't count that. Number two, sir, sa Persia, meron tayong Zoroastrianism. There is also the god Ahura Mazda. Why are we not counting that? Oh, because it only is exclusive in Persia and in the Persian Empire. Hindi naman siya nagtuloy hanggang ngayon. Wala na siya. So, we don't count that. So, what we count really is Judaism as the foremost monotheistic religion. Okay, going back. Judaism as a monotheistic religion regards only one God as above all the polytheistic religions or all the other gods of the polytheistic pantheons of the Mesopotamian region. Isa lang ang Diyos nila. At importante diyan yung idea of covenant. Now, sabi ni Jenna, Judaism is a religion developed among the ancient Hebrews. It is characterized by belief in one transcendent God who revealed himself in Abraham, and God is the only God that they worship. Okay, correct. Let's simplify. Ano ang heart ng Judaism? If it is about covenant with God, ang heart ng Judaism is one of fidelity. Yan! Fidelity! Ano ang ibig sabihin ng fidelity? So, if religion tells us to be good people, sa Hinduism, ang goodness, respect for other people. Sa Buddhism, ang goodness is control and moderation. Sa sa Judaism, ang goodness, fidelity to God, fidelity to people. Anong ibig sabihin yan? Sumunod ka ng 10 utos ng Diyos. Worship God. Offer Him all due respect. Offer Him oblation. Yun ang fidelity. Pag sinabi, nasasamba tayo, sumamba tayo, hindi pwedeng mag-absent. Tapos pag sinabi mong fidelity to God, following the Ten Commandments, huwag kang papatay. Huwag kang pumatay. That's fidelity. Following the laws that God set for His people. That is fidelity. Judaism talks about being faithful. Pero ladies, the problem with this faithfulness is that it becomes legalistic. Legalistic. Anong ibig sabihin ng legalistic? Masyado na siyang following merely the letters of the law. O, huwag kang papatay. Totally, hindi ka pumapatay. Pero, wala ka naman pakialam. O, sabi, huwag kang, ipa nga ba yung mga Ten Commandments? Respect your father and mother. O, nirespeto mo yung father and mother mo. Pero, wala ka naman pakialam doon sa father and mother ng ibang tao. O, diba? So, legalistic. Kung ano yung nakasulat sa batas, yun na yun. Tapos, dahil masyado tayo naguguluhan sa very concise meaning of the law, the Ten Commandments, anong ginawa ng mga teachers of the law? They develop other laws from the Ten Commandments. So instead of the Ten Commandments, it became 365. Oh, yung mga Judaistic yan, ha? Judaistic tradition. So let me just emphasize again. Judaism calls for virtue as being faithful. But the problem with faithfulness in the Judaistic tradition is it's legalistic. And that is what Christianity addresses. Yan. Papasok tayo ngayon sa Christianity. Yan. So again, this is not CL class. Okay? So ano yung sinabi ng Christianity? Yes, indeed. There is faithfulness that's necessary. Okay? And of before I proceed, I forgot to mention. So, yung Christianity, it was born out of Judaism. The early Christians were members of Judaism. And Christianity used to be a sect of Judaism. So, ibig sabihin, Christianity was part of Judaism. Okay? Ganun siya talaga. Doon siya nang galing. Now, similarly, yung history, parehas lang. Okay? Yung pinagmulan, parehas lang. And if Christianity is born out of Judaism, there is also value regarding that Christianity also upholds faithfulness and fidelity as a value. O, mahalaga rin sa kanila yan. Mahalaga rin sumunod sa batas. Mahalaga rin na mag-worship kay God. Mahalaga rin na mag-respeto sa mga tao. That's correct. The thing is that it overcame the idea of legalism. Sabi ng Christianity, hindi na siya legalistic dapat. Why? Because according to its traditional founder, Jesus Christ, it is not enough that we just follow the law, okay, with empty minds. Ano ang heart of following the law? Love. So for our Christianity, to be good is to be able to love. O, sabi nga ni Stacy, all Christian beliefs and actions are rooted in the primary teachings. Love God above all and love yourself. Ayan, ang sinasabi ng Christianity, be loving. Truly, there is value in being faithful. But faithfulness should be drawn out of love. Kaya nga, goodness for Christianity means being charitable. Yan, charity. Because charity is love in action. Yan, okay? So, the goodness for Christianity is understood as being charitable, being able to give yourself available for others. Okay? And if we will go to the scripture, the best example of that idea of charity which Jesus would like to portray to us is the story of the Good Samaritan. Ang ibig sabihin nun, be charitable to all, especially to your neighbor. Now the question is, let's just be CL for one time. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng neighbor? Oh, Samantha Teristong, what do you mean by neighbor? Samantha, what do you mean by a neighbor? Samantha? Oh, wala si Samantha. Let me ask Jenna. Jenna, what do you mean by neighbor? Jenna? Ano ibig sabihin ng neighbor? Maski yung very factual lang na meaning.
Excuse me, sir.
Si Jana po. Si Jana, si Jana. Jana, anong ibig sabihin ng neighbor, Jana? Ano, wala si Jana. Ah, sige. Jana, I'll get back to you later. Pinky, what do you mean by neighbor? Oh, ano ibig sabihin ng neighbor, Pinky?
The most common definition is someone near you.
Ayun! Tama, natumbok mo. Pag sinabi nating neighbor, hindi lang yung kapitbahay. Okay, hello. That's me again, neighbor. According to Sandra, with my face on it. Thank you, Sandra. Sabi ni Pinky, okay, it's okay, Eliana. Ang sabi na nga ni Pinky, neighbor means the one near you. Okay. So, pag sinabi natin the one near you, the one that is near you at any given moment. So, ngayon, ang neighbor ko, yung katabing bahay namin. Kasi siya yung nearest sa akin. Yung neighbor nyo, yung katabi nyo. That's your neighbor. So, whatever your neighbor is experiencing right now, you have to be sensitive on what's happening to them. And you have to be responsive to their needs. But the thing is that, when you say nearness, it is not just physical proximity, but also, it's okay, Samantha, but also, not just physical proximity, but also proximity as regards affinity. Yan! Okay? So, balikan natin. Pag sinabi natin Christianity, it's charity towards your neighbor. Let's just make that wider in perspective. That is charity, love, and service for others. Okay? Clear? Now, let me just, I forgot to mention to you. Who is the founder of Judaism? Traditionally, the founder of Judaism is Abraham. Pero, according to some researches, we better label David, King David, as the traditional founder of Judaism. Okay? Moses pala, sorry. It was Moses, or not David, Moses. Okay? And then, Christianity, of course, Jesus Christ. Okay, let's try to review. Goodness for Judaism is faithfulness and fidelity. For Christianity, it is charity, love of others. Now, there is also another Abrahamic faith, that is Islam. What is Islam? Okay, sige, again, 30 seconds, try to search for definitions, descriptions of what Islam is. Hanap kayo ng mga definition ng Islam. Ayan, bilis na Yumi. Islam is an Abrahamic religion teaching that there is only one God, taking Muhammad as a messenger of God, the world's second largest religion with 1.9 billion followers, or 24.9% of the world's population, known as Muslims. Okay, Muslims make up a majority of the population in 49 countries. And the biggest Muslim country in the world is in our region in Asia, Indonesia. Ayan, binigay na naman ni Sandra yung mga pictures. Nakikita natin yung Kaaba, nakikita natin yung minaret, nakikita natin yung crescent moon and star, maybe the Quran. Okay, thank you, Sandra. Kay Ozzy, sabi ni Ozzy, Islam is technically, it means peace, surrender, and putting these words together would mean the peace experienced by one who surrenders himself to God. Okay, very good. Mali yung reaction ko, Sandra. Hindi siya dapat tawa. Heart, yan. Tapos, it's okay, Sandra, don't worry. Samantha, sabi niya, main message of Islam is monotheism. Correct. Okay, Islam means peace. It also means surrender. Okay, katulad ng sabi ni Ozzy. At kay Darlene, sabi niya, submission to the will of God. Okay, very good. And so, what does submission to the will of God means? Yun yun. Pag sinabi natin, okay, Islam literally means submission to the will of God. Correct. Bakit ba kailangan mag-submit to the will of God? Because people are, again, during the time in the Middle East, are very much preoccupied by their polytheistic belief in many gods. Okay? Dahil polytheistic yung mga gods nila, iba-iba yung Diyos nila, nag-aaway-away din sila. Okay? So, iba yung idea of goodness ng isang taong nagsasubscribe kay God A. Iba yung idea of goodness sa isang taong nagsasubscribe kay God B. Kung kunwari, si God A, sabi niya, okay lang ang adultery. Kay God B, hindi okay ang adultery, mag-aaway sila. Okay? So, pag sinabi ni God A, okay, pwede lang pumatay. Pwede pumatay ng tao, lalo na pagkakalaban mo sa negosyo. Sabi ni God B, no, hindi ka pwede pumatay. O, tinag-away na naman sila. So, there is conflict. Now, if Islam is technically about submission to the will of God, that is submission to the will of the ultimate almighty God that is not given to any human caprice, emotions, or feelings. So, we are submitting ourselves to God Himself. But what does this submission mean? Ano yung goodness sa submission na yan? Okay? So, sabi niya, okay, ayan. Sabi ni Jana, submission pa rin. But we are now asking, what is the value of submission? What is at the heart of Islam? Technically, that will shape the culture of these people. Kasi alam natin, yung idea of respect of other people, shinape niyan yung kultura ng mga Hindu. Kaya nga meron silang idea of respect for other people, ahimsa. Yung Buddhism, kaya merong idea of being vegetarian kasi nga of the idea of moderation. Yung Judaism, fidelity, kaya nga ang taas-taas ng respeto nila sa Ten Commandments, ang taas-taas na ng idea nila doon sa Sabbath Day. Yung Christianity, yung charity, kaya nga alam natin, napaka-charitable, the heart of Christian faith is charity. Kaya nga sa atin sa St. Paul, charity impels us all eh. The charity of Christ impels us all. Pero yung Islam, surrender. Anong implication yan? That technically shape the culture of people who in 49 countries are followers of, sabi nga, 49 countries, majority of these people are Islam, are adherents of Islam, Muslims. Ano ang heart niya? The heart of Islam is justice. Justice. Because peace may be passive. Okay? Okay, you are at peace with yourself. But what does it mean? Justice means regarding people for the truth that they are. O, diba? Kunwari ha, simplify ko lang. Sino ang nagpasa ng group work na ito? Okay, sabi natin sa group work, ando si Samantha, si Pinky, si Stacy. Tatlo sila doon sa group work na yon. Pinasa ni Stacy. Pero ang tanong, pag tinanong ko si Stacy, Stacy, who really work on this group work? Eh, sa totoo lang, ang gumawa lang naman pala talaga si Pinky. At sinabi ni Stacy, "Ay, sir, I did it together with Samantha and Pinky. We did most of the part. I, Stacy, work on most of the part of our task. 50% actually. Tapos Samantha did 30%. Pinky only did 20%. Is that just? Is that fair? Is that the truth? No. Eh, ang truth naman pala, si Pinky talaga yung gumawa eh. So that is not just to the idea of Pinky, that is not just to Stacy. So pag sinabi natin justice, that is rendering to people what is due them. And what is the basis of what is due to people? The truth. Okay? The truth. Eh, pag sinurrender mo na ang sarili mo kay Allah, okay, pag sinurrender mo na yung sarili mo kay Allah, you will not be anymore preoccupied by your self-motivation, by your self-vanities. That is justice. Kaya tignan nyo, ladies, ha, sa Islam, they give so much emphasis on the idea of almsgiving, charity, faith. Oh, yan ha. Kanila yan. Almsgiving yan. In the declaration of faith, yung shahada. Ano yung ibig sabihin ng declaration of faith? Justice to God. We declare Him to be our own one, to be our only God. Justice. Sir, ang tanong, bakit po may mga terorista na mukha namang hindi sila fair, mukha namang hindi sila just. Binobomba nila yung mga bahay, binobomba nila yung mga buildings, pinapatay nila yung mga tao. Sir, bakit yung Abu Sayyaf nagkikidnap? Because there is an idea of extremism. When we say justice, on the virtuous part of justice, that is being grounded on the truth. But we cannot avoid the fact that there are people who are living on fundamentalism, that is extremism, going beyond, okay, going beyond what is justice in its virtuous form. Eh, sa kanila, ang justice, labanan ng mga kapitalista. Sa kanila, ang justice, labanan yung mga mapaniil na Kristiyano. Sa kanila, labanan ang mayayaman. Kaya nga, nagkaroon ng terrorism. Okay? So again, let us finish our discussion on Islam. Technically, you mentioned it already, the prophet of Islam is Muhammad. And all his teachings are collected in the holy book we call Quran. Now, simplify na lang natin. 5 minutes na lang. Si Confucianism, ladies. Okay? Confucianism. It was not founded by Confucius. It was not founded by Confucius. It was only named after him because Confucianism was organized by Confucius. Oh, yan ha, ladies, ha? Organized by Confucius but not founded by him. Why organized by Confucius? Because, ladies, he merely organized the thoughts and the histories of people who were during the time already subscribing to those beliefs. Inorganized lang niya. Inayos lang niya kung ano na yung mga existing beliefs ng mga tao. At ano ang heart of Confucianism? Anong ibig sabihin niyan? Ang goodness for Confucianism is being responsible. Yan. Being duty-bound to our responsibilities. So, goodness for Confucianism is doing what you are tasked to do. Okay? And much like Buddhism, ang Confucianism, wala rin siyang Diyos. Hindi Diyos si Confucius. He is not God. Confucius is a teacher. And he was merely teaching us what we are supposed to do as regards our responsibilities. Okay? Let me just change the spelling. O ba yan? At ganun? Okay, wait. Yan. Okay? So that's it. So yun yung Confucianism. Sinasabi lang niya, be duty bound. Particularly, you as a follower of a father. You as a student of your teacher. You as a, what do you call this? A follower of a political leader. You as a part of a family. You as an older, a younger brother or a younger sister to your sibling. Be duty bound to your responsibilities. That is goodness for him. Because a righteous person for him, being righteous, is being able to do well your responsibilities. Okay? That is for Confucianism. Now, for Taoism, okay? Ang Taoism, ladies, ang ibig sabihin niyan ay also Taoism, much like Confucianism, it was not founded by sino ba to? Lao Tzu. Okay? It was not founded by Lao Tzu. It was organized merely by Lao Tzu. Yan. Inorganized lang siya ni Lao Tzu. Katulad siya ni Confucius na inorganized lang yung mga existing practices into Confucianism. Si Lao Tzu, inorganized lang din yung mga existing practices and beliefs into Taoism. And what is the idea of Taoism? What is virtue for them? Virtue for them is attaining balance. Balance. Anong ibig sabihin ng balance? Oh, merong mga drives ang environment, may drives ang nature. Do we just give in to the drives? How do we control these drives? How do we control our tendencies? That is what Lao Tzu is saying to us. Be able to control yourself. Be able to control the energies that are around you. Kaya nga yung Taoism, nandyan yung feng shui. Eh, ang feng shui hindi naman superstitious na, oh, di ganda bahay mo, ha? Lagay mo la mesa dito. Pinto dapat hindi harap bintana. Bawal yan. No, no, no. Malas. So, dapat may flowing water papunta pinto para pasok swerte. Pasok swerte. Hindi ganon ang Taoism, ha? Hindi ganon ang feng shui. Ang sinasabi ng feng shui, oh, eh, totoo naman, bawal maglagay ng pintuan katapat ng gate. Eh, pag may magnanakaw, diretso yung magnanakaw sa pintuan. Ganon lang yon. So, what feng shui is saying, let us try to moderate, let us try to balance the tendencies and energies that are coming into our houses and energies are brought forth by people. So, ang sinasabi ng feng shui, isipin natin, sa mga dapat ilagay yung pintuan, dapat ba nakatapat siya sa gate? E di pagka may magnanakaw nga, diretso siya sa bahay. Pag may dumi, diretso sa bahay. Pag may nawala, diretso sa palabas. So, ganun yun. So, Taoism, organized by Lao Tzu, emphasizes the idea of balance, and it is most suitably perfected with the idea of the ang tawag dito, the yin yang, the yin yang balance. Okay, and finally, let's finish Shinto Wisim. Shintoism. Shintoism is not a very popular religion. It's a religion that's technically exclusively felt in Japan. Pag nanood kayo ng anime, may mga temple, may mga art, may mga shrines that Shinto, those are Shinto shrines. Now, what is Shintoism about? Wala naman siyang definite founder. Okay, what is Shinto about? What is goodness for Shintoism? It is respect, reverence for nature. Reverence for nature. Shintoism talks about reverence for nature, respecting nature. Why is that so? Because in nature, there is what we call the kami. Okay, the spirits of the earth. Sa atin, sa mga Pinoy, ang kami, intindi natin dyan, engkanto. Okay? Anito. Ang tingin natin sa mga kami, ayan yung mga earth spirit, yung mga kapre, yung mga tikbalang. Yan. Sa atin, medyo negative, medyo dark. Pero sa kanila, sa Japanese culture, ang mga kami, those are nature spirits that technically make an impact on how we live. And so we have to revere them. Kaya tignan nyo, sa Japan, my God, ang imbornal doon, mahihiya ang imbornal sa Makati. Ang imbornal lang Makati, itim. Sa kanila, may koi fish pa. Okay? Diba? So, that is why they are a... Okay, Stacy. Okay, Stacy, let me just clarify to you. The kami are not gods. Hindi sila Diyos. Okay, they are spirits or energies in nature. Kaya nga sabi ko kanina, sila yung mga engkanto, mga kapre, mga tikbalang sa Philippine mythology. Pero sa kanila, these are kami, they are existing in nature. They are the ones who technically resides in nature, who makes nature function. Yan yon. Okay? So I hope you are able to understand the lesson. Nag-overtime si Sir Bunyan yan tatlong minuto. Okay? So, I hope you are able to understand the run-through of all the religions in Asia and how it makes an impact on the culture of people. Technically, culture is affected, shaped by this religion, how? By their emphasis on how these religions understand goodness. Let me again just have a run-through. Goodness for Hinduism, respect for people. Goodness for Buddhism is moderation and control. Respect for Judaism is fidelity. Goodness for Judaism is fidelity. Goodness for Christianity is charity and love. Goodness for Islam is justice. Goodness for Shintoism is reverence for nature. Goodness for Confucianism is our regard and being duty-bound to our responsibilities. And goodness for Taoism is balance. Take note how these ideas of goodness affect and shape the culture of these nations in which these religions are practiced. Makikita nyo yan. Kitang-kita siya. Okay, that's it, ladies. Thank you and goodbye. I'll see you again next week. Bye.